Hi, my name is Daniel Bogdanoff. Welcome to this week's 2-Minute Guru. In last week's video, I promised that we would look at some environmental factors that can inject noise into your system. So that brings us to the first and hopefully last episode of the Noiseodile Hunter. We're gonna go out into the wild and look for some crazy noise. What was that? Lose the accent? I'm a professional voice actor. And besides, all of the big electronics YouTubers have distinct accents. We have EEVBlog.
What accent? I don't have a bloody accent.
electroBOOM.
What accent? I'm fluent in broken English.
GreatScott.
Wait, what accent?
All of them, crazy accents. So let's go find some noise in the wild. All right, so I've got my trusty battery-powered scope and my noise catcher, also known as a probe. This is basically like a big antenna if you think about it. So if you're making measurements, you don't want ambient noise coming in and messing up your measurements. So let's go look around the building, see what kind of ambient noise you have to watch out for. Let's take a look. All right, this room may look harmless, but there is some hidden camouflage noise. Let's take a look. When I hold this probe up to the light, let's see what happens. Oh, 320 millivolts peak to peak. And this projector here, it looks harmless, but it's out to get you. Let's see. Whoa, I'm seeing 180 millivolts peak to peak coming from this projector. So let's take a look under the hood of this old car and see if we can rustle anything up. I'm getting up to 5 volts peak to peak coming off the spark plugs of this car. So let's check this monitor. Looks like I'm getting like 110 millivolts peak to peak. Thanks for watching this week's episode of the 2-Minute Guru. As you saw, there's a lot of factors out there in the environment that can affect your measurements, so be careful. And as always, like our Facebook page, subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you like this video, tell your friends, hit the share button below, and I will see you next week. Thanks for watching. So I'm sorry if you're offended by my horrible, horrible accent.
Why? They probably went back to their cubicles and just started bashing their head against the desk.